her black tiara, red jams upon her fingers. She came from distant waters where northern lights explode, to celebrate the dawning of the new ways of winter, the gathering romance on the ice fields of old. And with kilmes swirling like petticoats in motion, sighted on horizons for 10,000 years, the lady of the ice sounds a deadly distant rumble, the Titanic bringing children off the melting Christmas cheers. Oh, sunshine, take me now away from here. I'm a needle on a spiral in a groove, and the turntable spins as the last one begins, and the weatherman says something's on the move. In a glass fronted museum, the white queen rose on the chessboard of the dawn, squeezing through the valleys, pulsing briefly in the chorus, the ice mother fades, and a new year born. Oh, sunshine, take me now away from here. I'm a needle on a spiral in a groove, when the turntable spins, that's the last one begins, and the weatherman said something's on the
effect an introduction regarding the other members of our little group here on the stage. Are going to say hello. First of all, over there on the far keyboards, learned gentleman, father of four, Mr. David Gerald Palmer. David! And on the other keyboards, your favorite ice cream salesman of the month, Mr. John Evans. Hello. Usually to be found behind his mighty blue Ludwigs, but tonight having a dabble on the bass, Mr. Barrymore Barlow. Diminutive in stature, but a giant when he's plugged into his dwarf mandolin, Mr. Martin Lancelot Barre. And someone only been in the group for one tour now, this is the second event, as it were, featured in the next song. He penned this one himself. Old Wobbly Knees, Honest Dave Begg, with a great fantasy about his future life when he hopes to own his own boozer. He's modestly entitled this one, Peggy's Pub. Peggy's Pub. Hooray. Thank you. Continuing in a rural vein, we'll play a little song which is all about this chappie who's supposed to live in the depths of England's green and pleasant land and looks after all the things that grow, keeping them alive during the cold winter months. His name is Jack in the Green. Have you seen Jack in the Green? Oh, with his long tail and the hat down, he quietly sits on the rosemary tree. He drinks from the empty acorn cup, and the kill the dawn sweetly descends, and taps his cane upon the ground. He signals the snow dump fish dies a ground. It's no fun being Jack in the Green. No place to dance, no time for song. He wears the colors all the summer song, yeah, and carries a green flag all the winter long. Jack, do you never sleep? And does the green scale run deep in your heart? Oh, or will these changing times or to waste our lives, keep us apart? Oh, well, I don't think so. I saw some girls going through the papers today. The charges then to groove. Each blade of grass whispers Jack in the Green. Oh, Jack, please help me through a winter's night. And we are the berries on the honey tree. And the missile thrush is coming, Jack, put out the light. Now to make the thing go with more of a bang. But once again, this is a song that's definitely sort of British in flavour, if you see what I mean. Who better to introduce it than old David Palmer over there, who knows what it's all about.
Thank you. And the next piece we're going to play isn't written entirely by Jethro Tull. It was written in the greater part by another Englishman, almost as famous. That man was King Henry VIII of England. He wrote two hits. The first was called Greensleeves, and the second is the piece that we're going to play for you now. And if you could imagine Henry VIII having a rock and roll band, it probably wouldn't have sounded anything like this.